Only Allah knows the nature of this saq. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ الْبَصِيرُ. There is nothing like unto him, and he hears all things and sees all things. So we will not dwell into the description of this reality called as-saq. The Muslims, the believers will see it, and then they will be called to. Baby, you can call me a superman.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel.
It's your boy Jesse Keegan
and your girl Fanny Lungu,
and we are Fanny and Jesse. So right about now we're gonna do another reaction. Before we get into the reaction, guys, I want to thank everybody who have been, you know, giving us reaction videos to react to, been subscribing to our channel. You're the realest MVP. And again, we want to thank everybody who have been able to, you know, hit that subscription, hit that notification button, so that you'll be the first person to watch our videos. You're the realest MVP. So right about now we're gonna do another reaction, or rather a video, and a lot of people suggested this one, and they suggested that we should go react to the prophets on Judgment Day. So without any further ado, guys, let's get it.
Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, on the day of judgment you will reach a position of misery. People will be miserable. People will, some of them will be saddened. People would have given up hope in some ways. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the long hadith. The people will gather each other and they will begin to question, what's going to happen to us? And so they will remember the prophets. Let's go to the prophets. Let's ask them. Let's come to them and ask them to intercede for us, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can begin the judgment, the hisab, the accountability. Prophet ﷺ said, in this life I had a dua. And this dua, I kept it. Whereas every other prophet was given their dua which they asked for. As for my dua which I kept specific for me, was that, oh Allah, save my ummah on the day of judgment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, behold, your Lord may raise you a beautiful raising on the day of judgment. What is that? It is the raising of the intercession. And this is the way it'll go. He said, the people will go to Adam alayhi salam, and they will say to him, Ya Adam, Anta Abu al-Bashar, you are the father of all mankind. You are our father. Allah created you with his hands. Please intercede for us on this day. And then Adam alayhi salam will say, Ilaykum anni, ilaykum anni. Go away from me. Please go away from me. Inni akhafu mithla alladhi takhafu. I fear the same thing you are fearing. Inni asaytu rabbi. I disobeyed my Lord once. Inna rabbi qad ghadiba ghadaban lam yaghdab mithlahu qat. Today my Lord is in a state of anger which he has never been angry like this before. Go to the one who is after me. So we go to Nuh alayhi salam, and we say, Ya Nuh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you. You are the second father of mankind. Intercede for us for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to begin the judgment. And then Nuh alayhi salam will say the same thing. Ilaykum anni, ilaykum anni. Go away from me, go away from me. I fear the same thing you are fearing. I made my dua upon my people. My Lord is angry in a state where he has never been angry like this before. Go to the one after me. Go to the one after me. So then we go to the next prophets, till we reach Ibrahim alayhi salam. And Ibrahim alayhi salam on that day would also respond in the same way. Go to the one after me. We keep going from prophet to prophet. This is all the Muslims and all the disbelievers, everyone. So then we go finally to Musa alayhi salam. And Musa alayhi salam responds in the same way. He said, then we go to Isa alayhi salam. And Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, responds in the same way. And he adds, the people took me as a god. Therefore today I am not qualified to face my Lord. How am I supposed to face him? I've got an answer to this. I've got something I have to answer to. The people took me as a god. Go to the one after me. I am not qualified for it. Lastu laha. Finally, we reached Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, this is what I have been favored with on that day, that I will be given an intercession for you people. And the only intercession I will be given for is for my ummah, for only for my nation who followed me. As for the rest of the nations, they will have to go behind their prophets, behind their imams. And everyone else who was disbeliever will go behind whoever they used to follow. So whoever their authority was, the angels will say, go to whoever you used to follow. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when the people come to me and they say, please, ishfa' lana, intercede for us for the judgment to begin, I will call out on that day and say, ana laha, ana laha. He says, thumma asjudu li rabbi sajda. I prostrate to my Lord, such a prostration, so prolonged. Only Allah knows how long, ma sha Allah an asjud, as long as Allah wills for me to make sujood. And I call out to Allah in such a dua that I've never called out before in my life. I've never used these words in praising Him and calling out to Him in my sujood. And then my ummah who followed me, they will prostrate behind me. A caller will call out, prostrate down to your Lord. Allah says in the Quran, on that day, a saq will be revealed. What is this saq? What is the true nature of this saq? Allah only knows. In Muslim, the book of Muslim, the Prophet ﷺ says, my Lord reveals his saq. Only Allah knows the nature of this saq. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ الْبَصِيرُ. There is nothing like unto him, and he hears all things and sees all things. So we will not dwell into the description of this reality called as-saq. The Muslims, the believers will see it, and then they will be called to prostrate. So then, bi-idhnillah, we prostrate. Except for the hypocrites. Allah says, فَلَا يَسْتَطِعُونَ. They will not be able to prostrate. And the disbelievers will not be able to prostrate. As for the Prophet ﷺ and his ummah who are still prostrating, the hadith says, فِي ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ يَنْزِلُ اللَّهِ. On that day, Allah will descend. How will He descend? What does descending mean? Only Allah knows the nature of this descension. And Allah says in the Quran, on that day, your Lord and His angels will come. The angels in line like soldiers. And Allah's throne will be brought. What does this throne look like? Only Allah knows. But it will be brought, and there will be eight angels carrying Allah's throne. These angels, the description came in the hadith, that they are so humongous that it will take 300 years journey for a person to reach between the shoulder and the earlobe. They look in that nature. What the earlobe looks like, Allah knows. What the shoulder looks like, Allah knows. But the point is, these angels are humongous. Eight of them carrying Allah's throne. The Prophet ﷺ said, the sky, the worldly sky, this universe that we see, compared to the second sky, because there are seven skies Allah created, is like a ring thrown into the desert. And the second compared to the third is like a ring thrown into the desert. And the third compared to the fourth is like a ring thrown into a desert. And so on until you reach the seventh. And the seventh compared to the arsh, to the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is like a drop, in one hadith, like a drop in the ocean. وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And there is Allah's kursi, which is above the throne. And the kursi encompasses the whole skies and the earth. It's even larger than the arsh, than the throne. That will be brought on the day of judgment. And then Allah will say, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, irfa' ra'sak, lift your head, was'al tu'ta, and ask for anything, I will give you. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lifts his head, and the only thing he will say is, Ya Rabbi ummati ummati. Oh my Lord, save my nation, save my nation. The ummah of the Prophet ﷺ. And he will know them. Rasul ﷺ will know his ummah which he interceded for. How will he know them? When the Prophet ﷺ was saying, I will be waiting for you at the Hawd, he said, follow my sunnah and stick to it. What I am on and my companions, stick to it. and I will be waiting for you there, and I will call you and say, come and drink from the fountain. شَرْبَةً هَنِيئَةً مَرِيئَةً لَا يَضْمَأُ بَعْدَهَا أَبَدًا. Prophet ﷺ said, you will drink from it. A drink that you will never, ever be thirsty after that again. Thirst as in the quenching of thirst which brings you to fatigue. That's the thirst we're talking about. You will never be thirsty like that ever again. And you will enjoy it. This fountain on the Day of Judgment, he says, it will be colored like milk. You'll say, this is like milk, but it's not like the milk of this earth. It will taste sweeter than honey, but not like the honey of this earth. And you will have cups of gold and silver. Some of the ummah of the Prophet ﷺ, we ask Allah to let us drink from that. I mean, will drink by themselves. And some of them, the Prophet ﷺ will give them to drink from his blessed hand, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before the Prophet ﷺ died, he went to his final visit to the grave of the shuhada, of the martyrs, and to al-baqiyah. And he made dua for them, and then he said the following words, وَدَدْتُ أَلَّوْ رَأَيْتُ لَوْ أَلَّوْ رَأَيْنَا إِخْوَانًا. The only thing I will miss of not seeing is that I will die not seeing my brethren. And then Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, Ya Rasulullah, أَوَلَسْنَا نَحْنُ بِإِخْوَانِ. Are we not your brothers already? Look, we're here, you can see us. He said, Ya Abu Hurairah, you are my companions. Yes, and you are my brothers. But the brethren I'm talking about, they are not here. هُمَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِي وَلَمْ يَرَوْنِ. They are the ones who believed in me and followed me, but never saw me, never met me. We ask Allah that we are them. Ameen. He said, what will happen? He said, I'm going to meet them on the Day of Judgment, and I will call them to drink from the fountain. He said, كَيْفَ تَعْرِفُهُمْ وَلَمْ تَرَهُمْ. How will you know them and you have never seen them? He said, if I told you that a person had many horses, and some of them were very black in color, and among them there were horses that were striped with white on their faces and on their arms and on their legs and on their tails. He said, well, isn't he able to tell the difference between these horses and those? He said, yes, very easy. He said, on the Day of Judgment, my ummah will come to me, ghullan muhajjalin. They will come striped with nur, brightness, nur on their faces. This is what it meant. It means on their faces and on their arms and on their legs. How did I know this? Because the Prophet ﷺ said, وَذَٰلِكَ مِنْ أَثَرِ الْوُضُوءِ. This is because the effect of the wudu they used to make. What does that mean? It means they used to pray. They used to prepare for prayer. They were purified by making wudu. إِسْبَاغ الْوُضُوءِ, he said. إِسْبَاغ الْوُضُوءِ. They used to not only make wudu, they used to make their wudu proper. So they would go a little bit beyond their knee, their elbows, a little bit beyond their ankles. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, after that day, everyone I saw, I used to say to them, whoever wants to drink from the fountain of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, extend your wudu. Like, make it better. Make it better. Or do it like the way Bilal radiallahu anhu used to make it. Before every prayer he used to make wudu, whether he still had it or didn't. There will be people whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he intercedes for them, they'll be turned away from the fountain. See, there will be angels standing there. And the people will rush to that fountain. They will see that this is salvation. So some of them will be prevented by the angels. And they will look like, Prophet ﷺ will say, are they from my ummah? And some of them, the Prophet ﷺ used to know from this life. And you'll say, they are from my ummah. And Allah will say to him, they changed after you. They changed after you. Meaning they changed your sunnah after you. The innovators, the ones who apostated, they changed. And the Prophet ﷺ will say, sorrowness and depth of hellfire for those who changed my sunnah after me, those who changed my way after me. My brothers and sisters, this is when, at this point, this is when the sky above us will be filled with darkness. We look up, and what do we see? We see our books, our records.
Wow. That was amazing.
What do you think?
Wow, such an amazing, what do you call it, story or video. I mean, I've always been thinking about, I've been asking myself questions. Prophets, back in those days we used to have prophets, yeah? And they used to foretell the future and stuff like that. Why is it that at this time, at this day and age, we don't have prophets who like we can bluntly see, and who can actually probably tell us the future, or probably mention the things that are going to happen in the future, something like that.
Yeah, they're there. People call them false prophets. No one wants to believe in any prophet that exists now.
Yeah. They're there, but is it because that people don't want to call them real prophets because of the things that are happening in the world?
Some people really believe in them, but there's some people that are saying all this is fake, so what can you do about that?
Okay.
Don't you think now you become the person who did?
I mean, it's really hard to even trust anybody nowadays, such that it becomes so personal to yourself, or even to, I don't know, it's just something really hard to believe in somebody at this day and age that we live in today, because everything is just misconstrued or stuff like that. But anyway, probably there are prophets out there who are true. And according to what has been said here, I think it's important to understand the fact that Judgment Day is going to come, whether you like it or not. I don't know how we're going to be judged according to our sins, according to how we used to live. You get it? But according to the scriptures, there are different. There are ways on how we're going to be judged. And I believe if you live in a righteous way, be it in any religion, and you follow the right path, I think you'll be in a position to be, to go to heaven. You know, what do you think?
I don't know, that really depends, because the entire time I was watching this, I've been thinking, do Christians, or let me ask this, do Christians think that it's only Christians that are going to go to heaven, that will be saved on Judgment Day?
I think that's the same mind concept the Islam do have too, because they believe Islams are the only ones who are going to go to heaven.
So we have these two religions that think like that. What about the rest of the religion?
I think they also have. I think they also have the same belief that they are the only ones who are going to heaven.
You think so?
Yeah.
You really think so?
I don't know. Probably.
I just wonder what makes one religion think they're better than other people. Why should you sit down and say, okay, we are the safe ones, and the rest of the people, what?
They're not saved.
Will not go to heaven.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's something to really, it makes one feel so bad to even think about it, because
do I have to be like, one of the religions to be saved?
It's like being biased. Like segregating a group of people who you think, no, you people are not going to go to heaven. We are the true religion and we are going to heaven. Okay, if we start thinking that way, I think we are trying to debunk the fact that other religions or other humans are not fit to go to heaven, despite the fact even if they are they're righteous, or even if they are trying to be to live in a very purest manner. Get it.
Imagine in the beginning, Adam was the father of humanity, I guess. So if Adam came, who? He mentioned a lot. You don't remember the names?
No.
There was Adam, Isa. Jesus.
Isa is Jesus.
Abraham. Who else?
Moses.
Noah. Pronounce it as Noah or something.
No.
You don't know. And anyway, doesn't matter the rest. What I'm saying is, what's the whole point of learning about them, of trying to live the life that they were preaching, if all that they, if at the end of the day on judgment day they'll say, I can't help you.
Then
at the end of the day, it's only Allah that said, save my nation.
Mm-hmm.
What's the whole point of learning about them?
I think the whole point of learning about them is to have faith and probably to prepare people into I think it's just putting faith and preparation and learning, understanding. I think that's the whole factor. Because now, if we say we have to live according to their, like we have to live 100% according to their preaching, Abraham wasn't, these people at some point, they used to have their downsides, you get it? According, you know the way you can be, someone can tell you, please, just listen to what I tell you, but don't listen, but don't do what I do, you get it? I can tell you good things, and then you like what I teach, but you don't like my actions, you understand? So, for me, I feel it was just, it's just a way of preparation, guiding you.
Allah of Muhammad was the only one that did right by God.
According to the...
No, I'm just asking, according to your knowledge. Because of Allah, what you said.
Allah was the last prophet.
Do what I'm telling you, but don't do as I do. So I'm asking you, so Allah is the only one that did right by God?
According to what I've learned so far, Allah was the last prophet, and he was one of the, I mean, he was just good, you get it? Allah's attributes were way better compared to the other prophets. I can't talk much about that, but yeah. Anyway guys, if you feel like we reacted to this video in a better way, to give us a thumbs up, and don't forget to go down our comment section, tell us exactly what you feel about our reaction, and what do you feel about the video we just reacted to. Just let us know if there's any prophets at this day and age that we can follow, or probably if you like this is the right person. Anyway, so and the most important thing is, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Then we keep on subscribing, then we'll give us the motivation to do a lot of videos and to give you better content. And last but not the least, we're going to see you in the next video, and peace out.